The housing market is continuing to cool, with the average asking price around the country dropping now by $100,000 since it peaked in January. It's led to fewer people putting their houses on the market, with new listings down by 26%. So for more on what this means for Kiwis, I'm joined by Sarah Wood from realestate.co.nz. Morning, Sarah. Great to have you in here. So vendors are shying away at the moment from listing properties on the market?
So what we've seen over the last 12 months, and particularly when we maybe even go back last year, we had record numbers of low stock numbers, so low number of homes coming to the market. And over the course of this year, we've seen that really change. So we've had a lot more homes for sale. So overall, we have more houses to sell this year. But certainly in the last month, we've seen that year-on-year number drop back in terms of new homes coming to the market.
Okay, so housing stock is looking good, because for years we were just saying at the break, the story was how the housing crisis, the shortage of stock that we had. So we're seeing the stock grow. But are properties that are coming on the market, are they staying on the market for longer?
Yeah, so when we look at the 15-year average, they are on market for longer. So at the moment, it's double the time on market than it was a year ago. You know, but we've got
so when you say double the time, how long is that on average?
It's around 7 weeks, but it's very dependent. Right. That's the average, but it's very dependent on the property that you're selling.
You know, there was where you are.
There was a property down in my local area that I was walking past the other day, and it sold within 7 days. So right, it's very, very dependent.
Right. And when it is staying on longer, but we are seeing more people interested in the market. So is that because people are putting houses on their watch list. So people are watching, but not yet buying. So watching with interest.
So there's watching with interest. The property market is still transacting. So, you know, what we're seeing is, even from October to November, we've had a 5% increase in our numbers of people looking for property. So, you know, there are people coming to market. I just think they're surveying their options. You know, when the market dynamics change, it gives people more time to consider their options and do their research. And you'll see that, you know, buyers are doing that as well.
And having to calculate higher mortgage payments with higher interest rates now, right?
Yes, with the impact of the OCR changes and how that flows down into banks. So,
are you seeing more mortgagee sales with the recent OCR hike and interest rate hikes?
Nothing notable. So no, okay. No, nothing notable.
Because I'm watching with interest, I'm a renter, so we are kind of watching with interest on Trade Me as well, listings, about what's going on. And one thing that surprised me is people going from auction to negotiation to asking price within a matter of weeks. And some properties that I've seen drop their asking price by 100K maybe every 2 or 3 weeks. I've seen one property do it twice now in a month. Mm. Is that kind of concerning?
I think what it sort of shows
for the vendor.
For the vendor, I think, you know, there is a there's a realism around meeting the market. So, you know, properties that are well marketed, that are well presented and are well priced, you know, they're moving through. So, you know, in that instance, it's just probably a vendor being realistic about meeting the market and understanding where the buyers are at, because the market dynamics, they have changed, as you mentioned at the start. But, you know, again, it's very dependent on the type of property that you've got and at what price point and what part of the country it's in.
Yeah, there are definitely prices, I'd say, in Auckland now, where I know that property maybe a year ago would have sold for perhaps 1.3 million plus, that are now at 850K asking price, which has quite surprised me in terms of how much it's cooled. The economists are predicting that next year it will fall even further. I think ANZ predicted something about 22% in falling in asking prices. But with a continued projection of falling asking prices, what do you think the dynamic will look like next year, possibly?
You know, I think it's really challenging to try and sort of predict where the market's going to head. You know, we look back on, you know, ourselves, we get asked, you know, where is the peak of the market or where is the bottom of the market? And we really don't know until that's happened. You know, I think it's all about, you know, if you're a buyer, it's about, you know, buying the house that you need for you and your family. And certainly if you're a seller, it's about making sure you're marketing it properly. And, you know, those two dynamics will meet when the market, you know, when they're in the market that they're in.
Just quickly before we go, what's your advice for buyers or vendors watching?
My advice for buyers is, you know, take note of the market, but don't just buy for the market. You know, make the decision that's right for you and your family. You know, if you're a vendor, market your property well. Now's the time to make sure you've got the maximum number of buyers that come through, and also, you know, make sure that it's presented well and that you're realistic around, you know, where the demand in the market is at.
Okay. Thank you very much, Sarah Wood from realestate.co.nz.